Well, Chantal, thanks for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
Before I start grilling you on your business, I thought I'd just recap why we're here. Okay. So I'm a real estate broker and I'm involved with Parkbench. Mm-hmm. I'm the local representative in Leaside. Okay. And so what we like to do is interview local business owners as well as people who service the neighborhood. And I know you service the neighborhood. So I asked you to sit with me. I'm going to grill you about your business, like I said, and then we'll spend a few minutes just asking you some questions about the neighborhood in question, Leaside.
Absolutely.
Okay. So to keep it nice and official, could you tell me your name and your business name?
My name is Chantal Quayle, and I'm the president of CQ Business Coach, where we provide business planning and strategy consulting to small and medium-sized businesses.
Wow. Okay. So you've practiced that in the mirror a few times.
I practice a lot.
So could you describe, I know you just kind of gave us the two-second spiel, mm-hmm. but could you describe your business?
So what I do is I help my clients prepare an actual business plan document. So I provide two types of documents. One is just a strategy business plan, okay. if they just need help trying to figure out what their next step should be in their business, or I help them with the investor's business plan where they might need more help with financial forecasting to present their business to an investor to get funds.
So all of it's about business plans?
All of it.
Okay, good. And it sounds very specific. I have to say, I've known a lot of coaches and mentors and advisors.
Yes.
I've never known somebody before you who focuses on business plans. What made you decide to get into this business?
I realized that when I first started my first entrepreneurial business, it was in bookkeeping.
Okay.
And I realized a lot of my bookkeeping clients didn't have a plan. And I knew this because I was doing their books.
Right.
So I started to offer them business planning services on top of that, because you need to have a plan to know where the next steps of your business is going to take you.
Sure.
And where you're going. So realizing that there was a void in the industry, I figured I would fulfill that void.
That's so interesting. I'm imagining you kind of doing the bookkeeping stuff, you know, with the visor on and going, ooh, these numbers are not good. I can help these people in a different
yes,
way.
Absolutely.
Cool. Well, so you may have already sort of answered this, but what drives you? Like, what motivates you in your business?
I just love entrepreneurship.
Okay.
I love the ability of entrepreneurship to change your whole economic position. You can be struggling day to day with the job and all of a sudden you get an idea and you put forth this idea and some passion and energy behind it, and all of a sudden you have a business that's taken over what your job used to pay you and more.
Yeah.
And the magic of that just lights me up.
It must be really neat for you. I mean, I think we're both very curious people. Mm-hmm. You get to see so many, I mean, being an entrepreneur, starting a business, I mean, it sounds very mundane and ho-hum, but you must see so many different angles and different ideas. Like, it must keep it really fresh for you.
It really does. I get to work with so many different types of businesses and so many different industries. So my innate curiosity is always fulfilled when I'm working with a client in a new industry.
Huh. Awesome. How long have you owned your own business now?
This one specifically?
Yes.
Just over 5 years.
Okay. Yeah. And you've owned other businesses, so this is a perfect question. What surprises you the most about owning and running your own business?
Scaling. Building
okay.
your team.
Okay.
That is the biggest surprise. I mean, I knew it was going to be a lot of hard work and it'll take a lot of hours and you're wearing so many different hats
sure.
in the beginning. But when you're ready to grow and expand, just finding the right key people to help you with that,
it's funny because a solopreneur mm-hmm. can be a business owner, mm-hmm. but really they're a solopreneur.
Yes.
And so taking it from solopreneur to business owner
yes.
who has people under them,
yes.
That is challenging.
It is.
What are some things that, or even one thing that people would not really know about your business? Maybe what goes on behind the scenes or the time it takes to do certain things?
How much effort and time I really put in to
okay.
the business plan. Like, I tend to dig more and more and more. And even though they pay me for a certain amount of hours, if there is more that needs to be done, I will still go find that more.
Okay.
Because it not only benefits them, but it also benefits me to
right.
know what's going on a deeper level.
So it almost sounds like customers of yours might think that there's some sort of cool template that you figured out and that you just plug stuff in and
no.
it spits out a result.
No, it does not work.
It's not really
way.
How it is. Eh?
No, it does not work that way. Every business is unique.
Yep.
Every business has a unique challenge and every business owner has a different goal.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no template for your goal. You know, your strategy has to be aligned with where you're trying to take your business.
Makes sense. And we've worked together. I
yes.
mean, I know that I assumed so before, but I've lived this with you.
Yeah.
Depending on the industry, you have to go and upgrade your knowledge of
Absolutely.
That specific industry.
Absolutely. It keeps me always, I always have to level up
yeah.
to provide better service and more value to my clients. And I love that challenge.
Cool. Speaking of love, if we had a bunch of your customers in front of us,
mm-hmm.
what would they say that they love about your business?
My professionalism and the fact that I truly care about them and I want them to see the result that they want to see. So I think my clients really love that about me, and we end up being lifelong friends. Like, it doesn't, the relationship never ends when I hand them the business plan.
Right.
It's a continuous relationship, and they always come back to me for more advice.
It's I guess it's interesting. I hadn't thought about it that way, but it's a pretty intimate relationship, right? I mean, a business plan has to take into account kind of somebody's resources, their what drives them, their fears, all of that stuff.
Everything. So. And they count on me to motivate them and help them see clearly the path that they're trying to go on.
Very neat. So have you ever had an odd request from a client or any industry that's, you know, oh, I wanna design this doodad, and you're like, that's not appropriate, or anything odd that you've had from clients?
Not odd requests for their businesses, but more odd requests for my time. Like, some of them would like me to just come in and run the business for them.
Oh, really? Because your other hat is CEO. And
yes, exactly. So funny. They don't realize I'm busy running mine.
Sure.
Right? And I'm good at what I do, so they like to just input me in their business and make it run that way. And it's like, no, you have to make it run yourself.
Well, that's kind of flattering, though, right? I mean,
well, yes.
Basically people wanting to hire you to to come on in. So we're at the beginning of 2019, and most people, I mean, especially considering what you do for a living, most people kind of try to plot out what are they going to do for the next year. So do you have any business goals for the next year?
Absolutely. I'm looking to create an online course.
Okay.
Because I want to help more people, and the exchange of my time and helping my individual clients is not going to be most effective for me, and I can't help as many people as I want to help.
So. Fair enough.
That's my business goal.
So is that why you're so good on video? Have you been practicing this for your online course?
I've been ready for this moment for years.
And what will the format be? Will it be kind of, you know, read a bunch of stuff that I give you and answer these questions? Or will it be, you know, in videos, sometimes people say talking head. So will it be your head kind of saying, hey, and then you might want to do this?
Yes, it'll be my head on the talking video with worksheets accompanying them on the steps to go through to build their business plan on their own. And at the end of it, they will have the option of, I guess, purchasing time for me to actually go through their individual plan with them.
Smart. So you're going to show them how difficult it is
yes.
to actually develop a good business plan. Though some people might manage,
right, sure
in all fairness.
Will, and I want them to.
Yes. No, I understand that. But very likely, I mean, people who are very serious about it, or if it's a large enough amount of money or time at stake, they'll probably say, hey, I realize I can't do this on my own.
Absolutely, and that's what I'm here for. I'm here to help.
When are you planning on launching this?
Spring.
Oh, you have that set.
Yeah.
So a couple months?
Yes, a couple months.
Oh, wow. So are you in full production mode of this right now?
Yes, I am. Okay. I've built out all the modules, and I've actually hired somebody to help me get the courses online.
Fantastic.
And I have my video day scheduled to get everything shot. So, I mean, I have a plan.
So this is a test run. And will this be something that's hosted on your own website, or will it be a separate site that people go to?
It's going to be a separate site that people go to.
Very neat. Well, you have to send me an email about it when it's ready. So that's about your goals. What are your greatest challenges in your business?
Like I said before, scaling, building the team to support where I want to take my business is taking time to find the right people. Because remember, as a solopreneur, entrepreneur, you have to stop kind of what you're doing to get your business moving along to hire the right people to help you get your business moving along. So it's kind of like, you know, you're operating like an octopus, so many different.
I think it's called working on your business instead of in your business, right?
Yes.
and for you, when you say scaling, are you talking about hiring employees, or are you also talking about bringing on service providers that you can outsource things to?
Both. Okay. Hiring employees that are around me on a regular basis and bringing on service partners so we can attack bigger projects together.
Awesome. Do you have a specific, I mean, I know you talked about people trying to bring you in to run their businesses. Do you have any memorable experiences of working with a customer, good or bad?
Yes, a great experience. I helped a client create a marketing plan specifically for their app that they're going to launch.
Okay.
And this was about 2 years ago. And finally, the app has been launched and it's in the iTunes store. So just seeing it
from
conception to actually being out there, it's very exciting.
That is very neat. Yeah. Have you downloaded it?
Yes.
I did that. Okay, so I have one more set question for you, but before I get to that, because that's kind of the end of our, you know, me grilling you on your business, let's deviate a little bit. Could you explain a little bit, not give away all your secrets, but what's the formula when you're going through? You must have an interview time with a business owner.
Yes.
There must be materials that you need to collect.
Yes.
Could you spend, you know, not 20 minutes, but okay, don't give us your whole course now.
Okay, absolutely.
But just spend a minute or two explaining what's the process when you're.
So we'll have an initial consultation for me to get an understanding of the client's goals,
okay,
and where they're currently at in their business. Then they will provide me any material. So if they just want a strategy plan, if they had a previous business plan that they had, I'd like to see it so
sure,
I can see where I can tweak things for them. Or if they're looking for investors, I'm going to need to see their financials so I
okay,
can assess where they are and to fill the gaps. And after we establish those benchmarks where they're trying to go, I then provide the research and analysis portion. So that
okay,
I will go off and do my own thing, research their industry, where they're at, and where they're trying to go, and put the business plan together to create the steps for them to get there.
Gotcha. And how is it more common that you have people who are coming to you just as they're starting something, or they've been operating a business?
They've been operating a business.
That's more common.
That is more common.
Interesting.
So they've been operating for a while and realized probably that they're flailing in the wind and they need a plan.
Interesting. Okay.
And I don't mind, because at least now they come to me and they know for a fact they need my services.
Okay.
Whereas in the beginning, if you're not too sure, and sometimes people think about the cost to get a business plan done, they want to try it on their own.
Sure.
Then they try it on their own and realize they spent a lot of money when they could have gotten help to go in the right direction.
Or opportunity cost.
Exactly. Yeah. And then they call me.
Gotcha. And is there a formula for an existing business? How often should they be reviewing a business plan?
I think they should review it between 1 to 2 years, because things change.
Okay.
Things change.
And do you find yourself working more or less in different industries?
More in different industries,
yeah. I'm not asking the question properly. Are there specific industries that you find yourself spending more time in rather than others?
The tech industry.
A lot
of apps being developed right now.
Interesting.
And with the augmented reality technology and artificial intelligence, people are creating more products to service those industries. So I'm getting a lot of tech stuff there.
And I've interviewed somebody recently who's a mediator.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're making me think about my interview with her. Mm-hmm. How often is it that you're brought in to prepare a business plan? There's more than one chef in the kitchen and they have differing ideas in
yes,
the direction that the business should be going in. Does that happen?
That does happen.
Yeah.
Yes, it really does. And it's a different strategy, because now I have to listen to all of their needs and now try to find the common denominator between what
wow,
they all want. So it's a bit more challenging, but I mean, I love a challenge.
Yeah. Very neat. So coming back to your business specifically and the set questions that I have, is there anything exciting that you have going on? I know you mentioned the launch of an online course.
Yeah.
Are there any offerings that you want to highlight that people should know about?
Well, the course is not ready yet, but if you have an existing business and you're in the lease site area and you just want some direction on where your business should be going, what's your next step, give me a call and we can have a free consulting session where I can assess where you are now,
mm-hmm,
and perhaps determine if I can help you figure out a business plan to get to where you're trying to go.
I feel like we need to put that into a flyer, and as I meet with other business owners in Leaside, I need to leave that
yes,
as a leave behind. Okay, so we've gone through your business in pretty good detail,
mm-hmm,
so I'd like to ask you some questions about the neighborhood that I represent,
sure,
Leaside. So how long have you even known that the Leaside exists?
Oh my gosh, over 20 years.
Okay, very good. You're batting 10 for 10 so far. and what are some of the things that you like about the neighborhood?
I love the community. I mm-hmm, love the people. I love the new development that's happening here. I have friends in the neighborhood, so I come and I tend to
hang
out.
Oh, you're coming in and out.
Yeah, so I come and hang out in the neighborhood. So I just love that I see there's a lot of development happening here and a lot of energy and a lot of new businesses coming in.
Yes.
So that's exciting.
And it's interesting that you say that because I think everywhere in the GTA, NIMBYism exists.
Yeah.
So people will either embrace change or say, not in my backyard.
I understand.
I want fantastic barbecue meat, but don't cook it in my backyard. I want to be able to go and buy a new faucet for my renovated washroom,
yeah,
but I don't want a big department store in my backyard. So it's an interesting time, and you're right, there are a lot of changes,
yes,
and I think that it's a pretty mature neighborhood, but it still has some growing up to do because there's so much transition happening.
There is.
So what are some of the changes that you've noticed? You said that there's a big development coming. What other changes have you noticed in the neighborhood?
Really, a lot of the new malls and stores that are coming up, that's a lot of the big changes that I've seen. Because like you said, the neighborhood was older.
Yes.
And it didn't have a lot of development. And now it seems like there's breathing new life into the
neighborhood.
Which means that the community is growing, which means people are coming in here, which means that's great for our economy. That's great for jobs. It's great for business.
Of course you would take the business angle of looking at it. I fully agree with you,
exciting.
By the way. Yes, it is exciting. Change is good. Is there anything that you'd like to see improved about the neighborhood?
I think they are making improvements.
Okay.
I can't say really that there's anything that I'd like to see that they're not doing yet.
A lot of people living in Leaside would say that the LRT is taking way too long to build along Eglinton.
That. Yeah, there is the construction
aspect.
But
you're so positive that you didn't even bring it up.
No,
that's very kind of you.
That's really good. If they're building transit here, it means that it's easier access for the people living here and more business.
Yes, I agree. It will be good when it's done. So I don't think I've talked to you about this. Do you have an opinion on why it's important for people to shop local or work with local service providers?
Absolutely, because you keep the resources within your community and you're helping your community to grow. So by keeping the resources within your backyard, you're only helping those around you and people that you interact with on a daily basis. That's awesome. That's awesome for business. It's people you know, like, and trust, and you'll be able to see their development and contribute to their development.
That's a good point. It's funny, I've thought about you specifically when somebody said to me they were looking to outsource, like outside of Toronto for sure, I think it was into the US or overseas, business plan development. And I remember thinking, how will somebody far away understand the local economy, understand the driving forces that you probably need to know about when you're building a business plan?
It would be challenging, but that's where the scaling will come in. You have to hire a team in that area to really give you some insight on what's happening locally.
That's true. Good point. Are there any favorite places that you like to visit in Leaside?
Yeah, the Sunset Grill that they built up here, that whole area that they revamped. I love coming through there.
It's a local it's a local favorite, I think, for breakfast. So listen, you know that I'm a real estate broker. Do you have any questions for me about real estate in general, or
How is all this new construction and everything that's happening in the neighborhood affecting real estate sales?
Great question. I should have asked you this before we started. So I think that people will avoid, for example, the Eglinton Strip for the last several years. There's been a lot of drilling, a lot of congestion because of the construction. So I think people are avoiding being within immediate proximity of anything that's happening along Eglinton. But I also think that people who are a little bit further removed realize that it's a huge opportunity.
Absolutely.
It's going to provide fantastic transit down the road. So I think we see that reflected a little bit in the neighborhood prices. And I also think that for people who can wrap their minds around, you know, quiet Leaside, having, you know, a lot of condo towers over the next decade or so, there are some very, very large developments planned, as you alluded to. So I think that all of that is going to boost the amenities in the area. You know, some people will think fondly of the sleepy little stores along Mount Pleasant and Bayview that are not all around anymore. But I think I see it in a positive way, the same way you did. It's progress. It's change, which is good.
Change is good.
So I think that we've got good things in the works. It'll continue to be a go-to neighborhood.
I can't wait to see.
Thanks for that question. Well, Chantal, great to see you.
Thank you so
Thank
much
you for
having
coming
me.
To do this.